what it takes to be a lifestylist and how long it takes to be good. And if you guys find this interesting, please stay tuned to find out more. Talk about you guys' experience. I know your experience is a little different and your experience a little different. How long have you been working at LifePlayer now?
I'm gonna be here. I'm gonna be 2 years.
And then
it's gonna be 2 years working here.
I've been here at Lash Pilot 7 months now.
So you can see where the difference is. So how was your training like?
Well, before I started here, I thought training was just a one-day thing because usually outside of Lash Pilot, they only train you for about 2 or 1 day, and that's how my training was. And from then, I was just on my own, and I kind of gave up on it because it was just too many things to learn. So then when I came here, Tram was the one that helped me, and she trained me. And she said they did a 6-month training. So they start you from zero. And first you don't work on any models, you just work on your mannequin. And they make sure that you learn from the bottom, like from placing the lash into the lash correctly. And then from then you just move into the models. And I ended up getting better within 3 months of being here, and I felt more comfortable taking models. And from the 3rd month, I started taking my first clients, and just from then, I felt more comfortable with people and with everyone that came in to do their lashes.
Yeah, because I can definitely see the improvements that she's done in over a year. Starting off, I can feel like she had an idea, kind of had an idea how to place it, but didn't have much training, not much shaping, not much training how to find the right shape for a person or for a client. And so with Lash Pilot, she was able to do texture, shaping, isolation. If someone's uncomfortable, she knows what to do, make you feel comfortable. So she's not in a panic, and you're in a panic, she knows what to do. And then for Julia, like with your 7 months here, and then your training, how was your training?
So, like she said, my training started off with initially a traditional training class, and that was exactly a year ago. It was last March of last year, so I did the 2-day training class, and then after that, I was very much like lost and confused because I didn't know anything, and I didn't feel comfortable like working on an actual person because I felt like I would mess up their eyes. Like I felt very like just left on my own, and that's there's like a very a huge gap in like the lash training because that's how all the classes are. So I actually I wanted to continue with moving forward with becoming a lash stylist. So after that, I came to the conclusion I need to do another training. And I kind of thought like, wouldn't it be cool if like there was like an apprenticeship or something, like something where I was in a salon training. So I started searching for something like that, and then I found Lash Pilot Salon, and I enrolled in the Lash Pilot Academy. So I did that, and I was working on models, training with models out of Tram for about 3 months, and then I graduated from the Lash Pilot Academy, and then started taking clients here.
Okay, so from hearing your experience and your experience, it looks like the beginning is tough. Like it sounds like you do your research, you find what pops up first, you go with it, but it's not really well training. Like I think what sets Lash Pilot Academy training apart is that like we're very well thorough, we take the time to see where you're struggling with, we do ask a lot of questions, and I feel like we make you feel comfortable. So by the end of the day, when you leave here, you don't feel like, what did I just do?
I feel like it's more, being here is more like a family. It's not just like, okay, we're gonna throw you and good luck. No, it's like, hey, do you need any help? Like, let me help you out. Let me come in and show you how to do it correctly. So that's what's been helping.
Do you think it's a lot of skills to be a lifestylist?
Oh yeah, definitely. I think it's underestimated the skills needed that are, that you need to become a lash stylist, because you see a lot of people doing it, or you think that they're doing it. At least for myself, I assumed that it was kind of easy after the first class. That's it. Like I'm gonna be a lash stylist after that first 2-day class. So it's yeah, it's a lot.
Yeah, it's a lot that goes into it. It's not just placing a lash in a natural lash. It's about shaping, finding the right shape for their eye. Also their texture, because not everyone's lashes are the same. Sometimes there's curly lashes, there's straight lashes, and you have to know how to style all of them and how to place the lash correctly to everyone. And everyone's different, so it takes a lot of practice.
How about talk about the fills?
How would you explain the fills? So you know how clients come in for a new set? Some clients don't even know that they have to come for a fill. Do you think it's, how would you say your experience with the fill compared to like an everyday client to an outside fill?
Outside fills are very, like, it's a surprise all the time. You can never, yeah, you can't plan for it because you never know what's gonna walk into the door. But usually we find a lot of stickies. We find a lot of people that come in with overgrown lashes, and that's not safe for their lashes because as soon as the lash, like even in the middle, it's too heavy. So imagine someone coming in with like tips, with their lashes and the tip. It's even worse for their natural lash.
Lash palette, we do take in a lot of outside clients. What that means is that those clients have worked from another salon, from another stylist. And as you work as a lash stylist, a lot of part of it is that when you get trained, a lot of times those people get trained by a mannequin and not actual real life people. And when you get trained on a mannequin, it's different, it's totally different from working on a person. So once you get trained on a mannequin, you think, okay, I'm ready to take on a client. You get an outside feel, and it's completely different from a mannequin. So Sana and Julia will tell you their experience with their outside feel.
Yeah, so like the traditional training class, if they do have you work on just one person, what you are taught is just doing a full set, and usually it's like just a full classic set, when in reality 90% of the work that is done in a salon is fills, and not just one classic set like what you're trained in the class, and you're not trained how to do fills. So even leaving the traditional class, I remember thinking like, how do I do fills? How do I remove old lashes? And what do I do? Like, how do I remove the old lashes? Because I knew that. Like, I knew that fills are constantly done in the salon. So that was something that was extremely frustrating when dealing with the traditional lash training.
And what about your experience with the fills?
Like she was saying, they never taught me how to do a fill until I got here.
Yeah.
And, so when I learned here, I learned how to remove overgrown lashes. They were supposed to take out the overgrown, not just fill in. And in some places, they just fill in. So I learned how to do that. They teach you how to also clean the lashes and how to see when people need a new set. So how to recognize buildup. Not every salon tells you that there's buildup in the lashes, and mostly for people that wear makeup on a daily basis, they need a new set every 3 months.
And that's a big problem with a lot of academies or a lot of lash places, that they don't train well when it comes to doing the fills, or especially if you're trying to train to be a new stylist. It's important to learn the process of doing that outside fill or just a fill, because when you're removing the old excess lashes, it's good to remove them, because as the lash grows out, it weakens the more of the old lash gets closer to the end of your lash. So it tends to like bend down, and naturally it kind of like bends your natural lash, and then it kind of ends up twisting at the end with your lash extensions. And we don't want that to happen. That's where your natural lashes get damaged. And that's what set lash colors apart, because we want to make sure all the sellers are trained to remove all the old lashes, are known to removal and how to place correctly, so you can leave satisfied, and then the sellers know how to properly take care of you.
And I think the best part is that you're not just training in a mannequin, but you're training with real people, and that's the best part, because you get to train real lashes. It's not the same as a mannequin. Even mannequin lashes are even harder than natural lashes, because they tend to just go straight down. And then it's harder to place it, and then it's easier to remove it when you're a real person.
Yeah.
It's a little harder to remove it when you're that's what's great about here, that we get trained in real people.
Mm-hmm. And the nice thing about it is that, like, especially if you're training and you want to take clients at home, it's good to know our type of training, because when you go home and you have a client, they have a reaction. You know what to do when that reaction happens. Unlike other places, when they teach you, you do a removal and it starts burning and you don't know what to do. You just let the client lay there and just try to remove the water, but you're making it worse. And then you can end up getting sued or even something worse, you know? But it's important to have proper training and proper training about fills, because it could affect your client. Guys, thank you for watching our content. If you enjoyed our content and found this very helpful, please stay tuned. Next week we'll be uploading another video. If you have any questions, please add on the comment box below.